Both teams come into this one riding high after back-to-back wins. Mr. Vitale, this third-round game should prove to be a tight one between the Boston University Terriers and the Butler Bulldogs.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Bulldogs should have a cakewalk tonight, Dick. What are the keys for them, you think?
Hey, the keys for them should be straightforward tonight. First of all, the point guard has to be the floor general. It's up to him to ensure that his team executes and has efficiency on both sides of the floor. Second, make good decisions with the rock. Don't turn it over, baby. Finally, be aggressive defensively and force the offense out of its rhythm.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
For three, scorches the net. He'll regroup the offense. Turns it over. He keeps the dribble as they reset. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Playing for the steal in the post, and he didn't get it.
Ante tried to make the spectacular play, but now he's embarrassed.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Shows patience waiting for the reset. Passed on the guy in the post to go the other way. Tries a three, way off target. Trying to pack it inside. Executes the baby hook. They still don't score. Cross court.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball to the deck. Where's he going?
He dials long distance. He nails the shot. Fed the low block on the inside. Tries the turn. The defense comes up and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Inside, number 50 with the ball. And he missed. Great defensive clinic put on by this young man tonight, Dick.
You betcha. He's giving the offense the blues.
There they come with a double team to stop it.
Dump it inside.
Shots there if he wants it. For two, perfectly executed. Number 24 gets the ball. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me what.
He blocks the shot. Now they work it around the perimeter. He launches a three. 10 seconds to get a shot off. Inside. Number 32 in the paint. On the dribble, gives it up. Trifecta for the Knights. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. Nick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
The dunk counts and the foul, Dick.
He's a high riser, baby. Boy, was that pretty.
Number 31 going to the charity stripe for the first time tonight. They work it around the perimeter. Way out on top, controlling the ball. Number 13 is eager and excited to compete.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
Number 31 gets the pass. Doesn't go. Got the bucket and the foul.
He made a statement on that play, baby. I ain't backing down is his cry.
He goes to the line for the first time. It goes in.
Right there, they missed him inside. You got to get the ball when a guy is open. That's a special art, feeding the post.
And off the mark. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover there.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Outside. Had him in the post and didn't pass it in. Reverses it. Got the shot if he wants it. He attempts the three. Off the rim and no good. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Number 13 takes the feed.
Nice fake.
We'll take the shot. Way off target.
Push that basketball.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block. Look at that spacing. Got to take some pride on the defensive end.
Dick, they're giving this offense absolutely no good shots.
Because they're keeping their feet moving and their hands waving, Brad.
Number 32 looks to be down emotionally.
He needs for something positive to happen, which will light his fire and get him going.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket. Up and inside.
He fires from long range. The Bulldogs have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep getting the ball. It's simple.
The power forward takes the pass.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking out of box.
That's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I'll tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
The skip pass is picked off.
Tempo to game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Number 4 steals the ball.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Ten on the shot clock. He shoots from long range. I'm not sure that's who you want shooting the three.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
And he'll kick it back outside. There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
You're right, Brad. There is a mismatch. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Entry pass in the paint. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
Thanks, Aaron. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Had him in the paint, but went elsewhere. Number 32 with the foul. Third team foul. Number 21 looks to record his first miss.
He provides nice pusher offensively and defensively for this bunch.
Gets the first shot. Got it from the free throw line. Makes the third. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brad. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
He's doing a terrible job of distributing the ball.
They may have to pull him out and let somebody else out there. Let him think about it for a while.
Jumps in. Can't get the shot to go. This kid's been nothing short of magnificent on defense.
He's creating absolute havoc out there.
Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad.
Moving it around the perimeter. Number 21 is down emotionally right now, Dick.
I hate to see a young man struggle like this.
He'll go to the line. Misses his first shot. Makes the foul shot. Time to pick up the defense here now. Gave it up. I think he's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
Boston University are on a nice little run at the moment.
Hey, they have to keep pushing and seeing if they can force a timeout.
Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Number 10 picks up the foul. And Dick, look at this sellout crowd, and they are loving it.
Oh, they're ecstatic, baby. They're ecstatic. Great team play.
At the free throw line. Hits the first shot. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad. Makes those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby. I love that block shot, Brad. Really gives you a lot of momentum.
Number 31 makes a great move to draw the foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Number 31 goes to the line, shooting two. Makes his first. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Got them both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
That one, there should have been a foul called, I think.
Well, you take a look right there. I thought there was contact right on the defensive player.
He goes to the free throw line. Makes the first shot. Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. Nothing but nylon, NBA. The frustration right there.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
And a momentary look from three-point land. And that bucket's going to count plus one.
A big time and one, baby.
Number one makes his first appearance.
I tell you, this youngster can provide a spark on either side of the floor, Brad.
He goes to the line for the first time. He got it. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? He tries the three. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. The ball goes out of play. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
For two, they still don't score. On the dribble, gives it up. Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble. He makes the block. Off the rim and no good. Gave it up. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move. Great play to take that to the basket.
The Terriers have a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
He unloads. Off the mark with that shot. This defense is fierce.
They're fierce, and they're not afraid to take chances, Brad.
And he tries to spin away from the defender.
I tell you, he's versatile in the post. He's got the spin move and a number of other activities.
He lets it go. Poor decision. He has no business taking that shot.
Brad, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
He tries to knock down the three. Way off target. Down low, there's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step, very slow.
At halftime, the Terriers are up by 24. Looks like we're in for a whale of a game, Dick Vitale. Plays of the half, what's your pick?
Well, the trifecta, like we see here, was and will be a part of the story of this game. We'll have to keep an eye on which team gets it going from out there in the second half.
We're about ready to start the second half, Dick. Let's go down and see how this one unfolds. Butler had a horrible first half, Dick, in turning the ball over.
I see a lot of guys out there thinking too much when they have the ball. When you think too much on a basketball court, they try to be Aristotle, man. They got to be basketball players. The opposition has time to react. You can't let them have that advantage.
Block shot. And the ball goes out of play. You start comparing these backcourts, Dick. What are your impressions so far?
You know, well, for me, Brad, good guard play will take you a long ways. If you think about teams in the past, they all had good guards who can apply good ball pressure, attack off the dribble, and distribute the ball. I can't emphasize enough how important backcourt play is.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. The Bulldogs have a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
Goes up for two. Strong rebound.
Good rebound position. Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
The small forward receives the ball, looking for a screen on top and got it. The point guard handles the pass. Number 24 grabs it. Number 21 is called for the foul. Full house and a packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team.
Working around the perimeter. Looks for a three-pointer. Rims out. On the inside. For the deuce. Doesn't go. The shooting guard receives the pass. The shot won't fall. Blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
They're working around the arc. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Good fake. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Gets the rebound.
Men have got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
Didn't like what he saw in the post and reverses the ball. Tries for two. Basket falls despite the contact. Gives it up. He shoots from the top of the key.
How many bricks did we see? Will somebody make a jump shot, please?
The fake. Puts it on the floor and up and under. He's not even looking for the open man, Dick.
They might need a quick T.O., baby. The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Takes away the pass. Here they go into the break. They're going to call this one a backcourt violation, Dick.
You can't make mistakes like that too often, Brad.
He goes for three. It won't fall. He lost. launches the bomb. Tickles a twine. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
The power forward handles the feed for the bucket. In and out. They work the perimeter.
Ooh, look at a shot block, but he got some contact. Nice hops.
Ball goes out of bounds. He's mocking the crowd. Now that's throwing salt on the wound. The fans are definitely going to be annoyed with him.
Oh, Mr. Nestler, that's a no-no.
Pass down low. There's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Top of the key. Off the rim and no good. Decided against the open post and reverses the ball.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Got a nice screen. He throws up the shot.
He can't get the Jay to go despite running off the nice screen.
Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle there.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Gave it up. He attempts the trifecta. There's a very tight lid on that rim for him right now, Dick.
That's right, Brad. Nothing seems to be dropping.
He strokes it. Way off target. For the bucket. Not a whole lot of luck getting the baskets to fall lately, Dick.
They definitely aren't getting the bounces right now.
They work it around the perimeter. He unloads a three. Butler are on a bit of a run.
Let's see how long they can keep it on, Brad.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works. Another brick, baby. Building a new arena.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
The center takes the pass in the paint. Drops the bucket despite the harm.
That's a 9-zip run.
On the outside. Fires away. A severe offensive drop for them right now, Dick.
And it doesn't seem to be turning around as of yet, Brad.
He looks for the bomb. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Takes the pass in the paint. Trying to draw the foul. Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously, but they don't have the great respect. So they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Moving it around the perimeter. He shoots from outside. Off the rim and no good. We're going to move it around the perimeter.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Let's get a replay, baby.
Patty will kick it back outside. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Number four is pounded on his way up. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Number 34 walks out to get his first minutes tonight.
They have such a deep bench, Brad. This kid could start for any program in the land.
Except this one, apparently.
Well, you never know what the story really is.
Second one, good. On the dribble, gives it up with the fake. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Kicks it out. From the top of the key. Rims out. First half, both clubs shooting well, rebounding well, hitting their free throws, not turning it over. And in the second half, that hasn't been the story for that one club anyway.
Well, I think what happened at halftime, he really convinced his kids about really increasing the energy on the defensive side. Their energy is so much better. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For two, he puts it in with contact and all. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you know, points in the paint is a stat that coaches will readily look at, comparing their team's dominance in this category with opposition. Establishing that inside presence is an important facet of consistent success.
Well, I think she's right about that, Richie.
I'll tell you one thing, you better be able to establish post play because that gives you inside-outside action.
Picked out of the air. With a long bomb. Goes up for two. Off the rim and no good. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
He's got a nice shot fake. Gave it up.
Double team now, bad angle.
Butler have gotten themselves into a bit of a rhythm on offense, Dick. They're really on a nice run right here. On the dribble, gives it up. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Not getting enough motion on offense. Here they are in transition, Brad.
And he scores despite the half. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Cross court. Picks off the pass. Gave it up. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Got some room. Shoots it. Rims out. He intercepts it. High post flashes for the opportunity. For the deuce. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Working him defensively.
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help some.
He puts it up. No. He goes with a jump hook. Off the rim and no good. On the dribble, gives it up for the bucket. Butler are on a run right here as of late, Dick.
Yeah, they've started to put it together on offense. Can they keep it together, though? That is the question.
Working around the perimeter. Here's a double team. Stolen ball. We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
Aaron's right about that. Can we expect a little change in direction here, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if the schemes change somewhat.
Gave it up. Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock. Possession or timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Three-second violation.
Better watch your feet.
And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass. It's a two-possession game if they can score here.
He shoots from the top of the circle. The Bulldogs have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Daddy's on fire.
With the fake. They're working around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the circle. And he's no good from downtown.
Foul them early and give your team a chance.
Play about ready to resume. Shot clock is dead.
Inside.
Got the high pick. He looks for the bomb. That's not a good shot given his abilities.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Turnovers, Dick. They just kill you every time.
I'll tell you, Brad, they sure do. You must keep the number to a minimum in order to maximize your number of shot attempts.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. Well, Mr. Vitale, there's the foul situation so far.
Hey, Brad, staying out of foul trouble down the stretch of any game is vital. You want to keep your opponents off the free throw line and out of bonus situations.
And here's a look at the foul situation.
Well, Brad, fouling and knowing when to foul is an important part of the game. If you have fouls to give, sometimes it's better to commit one rather than giving up an easy basket.
At the free throw line. Opportunity makes the front end of the 1-1. He hits the second shot.
A bucket here is crucial.
To hit the floor. He tries the three ball. He's not getting himself in position for the good shot.
Yeah, it's a little bit too much. One-on-one.
All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on. One team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference of the game.
Boston University just wanted it a little bit more in this game, and because of that, they're going to live to play another day, Dick.
Hey, they're on their way to the Elite Eight, Mr. Nestler, where they'll be joined by the 7 best teams in the nation.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler. Good night, everybody.